Ladies, gentlemen, welcome to the colorful world of Skittles. Skittles brings you a jolt of five fruity flavors in every bite, giving you the chance to taste the rainbow like never before. Break free from the ordinary day-to-day with the help of Skittles chewy candy. Skittles is a must in my candy jar, movie snack, even my secret, so an afternoon pick-me-up, and I don't even care who knows it. Add a splash of joy to your day with Skittles. There's nothing better than fruity fun that tickles your taste buds. Taste the rainbow.
The dream is real.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, it's your lifestyle specialist, Kenny Burns, reporting live from Loveland. With episode 52, that's right, 1 year of TKBS. I can't feel my face. Round of applause for us. Yes, we deserve it. We deserve it. And ladies and gentlemen, I could not do it without my illustrious panel of superheroes, and they are the nation. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Coco, Kenya, Kendra, yeah. We're going to get to your faces today, baby. Ladies and gentlemen, keep those round of applause going. My brother Teules, a.k.a. Cousin Freaky. Yeah, we're going to have some freaky moments today. Yeah. The freaks come out at night. Is that the Running Man or the Cabbage Patch?
I think that's the WAP.
Keep those round of applause going for the one and only. She looks like she's in jail, but she's not. Ladies and gentlemen, my favorite, Dr. Sugar.
Hey, y'all.
Yeah, it don't happen unless we get to hey, y'all. Now, ladies and gentlemen, today, episode 52 is actually 52 weeks of the amazingness that we call TKBS Nation and TKBS and the Kenny Burns Show. And I am so honored to have this episode today because we had an idea, y'all, that we wanted to basically take the important conversations that we were having as a nation, as TKBS Nation, and put them into a weekly podcast to inform, inspire, and impact people's lives. And we have done that. Another round of applause for us. Huh? We're not succumbing to the pressures of the algorithm where it's telling us to post things that aren't going to be good for our souls and spirits. We are having conversations that are needed and wanted for real, and we are testimonies of that because people are tapping in. Ladies and gentlemen, over 100,000 downloads. We have, you know, all types of platforms. We on other podcasts going viral for our comments. All from this podcast. We are showing up everywhere else because of this podcast. And ladies and gentlemen, it's our anniversary. Gentlemen, I want to start this podcast off today, this multimedia experience off today, by saying congratulations to y'all. Like, do you realize that we started out with about 60 nation members coming in, adding value to help us get the engine started? And y'all pierced right through and became actual co-hosts of a global, you know what I'm saying, show. You know what I'm talking about? Can we get the
streets?
You feel me? So Sugar, I want to start with you, babe. How does it feel? Because you often say, I can't wait for us to do an episode that my daddy can actually listen to. But but I know several times throughout the year you have mentioned how people have stopped you, how people have came up to you. How has it been being a co-host on TKBS?
You know, honestly, because I did not set out for this, right, it has been a welcomed addition to my life because it feels like home when I log on with y'all. Like, when I tell y'all I was not having a good day today.
Right.
Everything in the world that could happen has happened today.
Wow.
Everything.
Wow.
And I literally had a whole attitude at the beginning of when we logged in, and I said, you know what? Gather yourself, put some lipstick on.
You put that red on.
Because you know you with your people.
Yeah.
You know you with your people and you safe.
Hey.
So I'm just grateful to be here and to know that I am safe with y'all and know that I ain't got to agree with what everybody says. I can have my own perspective.
Fact.
And I can continue to be me regardless of what's going on around me. regardless of what everybody else's input is, I'm gonna put my same regular input in because, I mean, you know, I know who I am. Amen.
Hello. Amen. Amen. Huh? You're taking the family to. Amen. Let the church pass the offering plate. It could be digital. Teule, brother, you have. I mean, in my opinion, and you could have been this the entire time, but you've grown so much in your delivery, even from the militant standpoint, you know, that you take often. You know what I'm saying? You loosened up, and I want to give a lot of that for your wife, to your wife, props to your wife for balancing your comments. But how have you been with this experiment that is now a way of life for us with TKBS?
It's, like Sugar said, it's a welcome surprise. But I take everything from a spiritual standpoint. I think it's a journey that God ordained, right? He used you as the vessel to start something. Even going back to episode one, where you say, hey, this is the conversation. This is not a podcast. This is an environment for conversation. Facts. And so I've just always tried to see, you know, how do I fit in? And to be a part of something that I think is God ordained, because I don't, you know, my time is super valuable. That's not to discredit anybody on here. I wouldn't just show up for someone just, hey, let's just do something.
Right.
Everybody tries to start a podcast, right? Everybody feels like they have something to say when they really don't. But I think this is a gift that God gave you, and I'm just super happy to be a part of the journey and to be able to grow and evolve and learn from, you know, these two sisters and from yourself and from all the individuals who had a chance to say something. So it's been an incredible journey for me.
Yeah, man. Round of applause.
Yeah, don't make me cry.
Nah, this is beautiful, man. This is beautiful.
Sweet.
No, but I received that, Teule, and I want to get to something after the lovely Coco Kenya Kendra tells us how she has, you know, enjoyed this experience. Because, child, it's your faces for us, okay? It's the faces. Every promo clip. And you make me smile. How are you feeling, though?
I feel great. Like, both of Teule and Sugar said, it was a surprise because I was just like, I was happy to be on here and have a platform to talk my shit.
Right.
You know? Right. My opinion. I like to give it. What's up?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So, I didn't know that it was going to evolve to the point that it is now.
Right.
I didn't know it was going to be to this point. But I'm enjoying the ride. I appreciate you for allowing me to be a part of it. Just my experience through life, sharing that with other individuals. Hopefully, some of the younger generations that tune in. Just sharing that.
Yeah.
Of
picking
what
up what you're putting
through
down.
And hoping that. Yeah, hoping no one else have to make the mistakes that I made.
Yeah.
So I'm happy to be here, and I love the people that I'm on here with from the bottom of my heart. I learned a lot from all of you guys in each episode and even outside of here. So
right.
I'm grateful.
Awesome. Well, we love you.
Ah! Yes.
I love you, motherfuckers. listen, no, in real life. But it's so special to have a place where you could come and feel safe and feel heard. A lot of us don't have places in our own lives where we could just really be heard. And this is a platform where tens of thousands, soon to be hundreds of thousands and millions of people are like, and it's actually probably thousands with all the reposting clips and sharing, but wow, what a play, what a thing to have achieved. No one would have ever thought that. And even to your point, Taylor, when you were talking about the first episode, mental warfare, we started out our journey with mental warfare. And we had so many isms in that. And you know, at that time, I was smack dead in the middle of Kyle's first two surgeries. You know what I mean? And I'm showing up like, ooh, I'm unpacking too. And here's some of the clips from that episode.
Like, you're talking about the social media atmosphere today where there's the illusion of success. There's illusion of being a visionary or a boss chick. But then you have a Kenny Burns who started from the bricks, who started with nothing, but yet was exposed to enough to say, okay, not only will I achieve that, but I am gifted enough in my own right to do it my way, my own style, my own flair. I think the illusion, the pressure of having the illusion of success and money and all of that is crippling creativity. It's crippling innovation. It's stifling the gifts.
Yeah, because listen, when we get to talking our talk, y'all, and get to sharing, I don't even think y'all understand the level of like spirituality, to Taylor's point, and connectiveness to Sugar and Kendra's point. Like it's like we lock in and we go somewhere. Like, is that not what it is? Like, I just feel like we lock in and it's supposed to be.
It's like, okay, you know how you don't have to think to breathe?
Mm.
I feel like I don't have to think to be here and be honest and be open and be authentic with y'all. I don't have to prepare for a conversation that comes from my heart. I don't have to prepare for being able to talk to people that I trust, that I know have my best interests at heart, that if I know I'm down, they gonna make sure I'm good.
Yeah.
Like, they feel it and they know, because I try really hard not... I gotta stop because I'm about to start crying.
Nah, it's fine.
And let's also say that we don't have preparation for this. Right. A lot of times we don't know the topic until that morning.
Right.
So there's no preparation. It actually comes from our heart and from our experiences.
You know why I did that though, Kendra, and why I continue to do that? Is because I feel like when we were going live during the pandemic, didn't nobody know what I was gonna say? There was no preparation in the authenticity.
We sure didn't.
Right? But the authenticity in the replies, you know, gave us a certain level of like vulnerability, and it peers through differently. Cause when you know something, you preparing, you know, and this is a forum, cause we don't just do it here for this hour. We go do lives, you know what I'm saying, at 7:30 that evening to talk through it more. So more of the people that originally started and other member new and old can join in and, you know, really talk about it. But you know what's crazy? Episode 3, big shout out to Beyonce, cause she inspired the title, You Can't Break My Soul. And y'all remember the song. Beyonce just came through with the delivery, you know.
Definitely.
But I feel like that episode, You Can't Break My Soul, like we were breaking down some very crucial things, right? And how we wanted to show up and how we wanted to relate. Do y'all remember that episode and how did you feel about it?
Listen, when Taylor said out of his mouth, ladies, patience does not have to be, what did he say? Patience does not have to be punishment.
Ooh.
Like, and I was in the middle of a breakup at that episode.
Wow.
And I feel, and he didn't know this, but I had said the words, like, I feel like you're putting me on punishment when you don't talk to me, when you shut down.
Wow.
And I'm trying to be patient through this and see, you know, and just have your back and not switch up on you and all of that. But when Teules said that, I promise you, I almost just laid out and just said, all right, I'm not doing this episode. I cannot do this. But like you said, KB, it's like when you used to always say, this is my therapy, this is my therapy.
Right.
I used to be like, okay, KB being a little dramatic.
No, I'm serious.
Do that.
I'm serious.
But where STG, I was like, oh my God, this is therapy for real.
No, listen, and that's Taylor, a round of applause for you, brother, because you've been dropping bombs. I'm talking about, like, I didn't even know. I thought it was just Cousin Freaky we were getting. I didn't, because you weren't really,
like, the man got layers like an onion.
Hey, bro, like, you have so many. Matter of fact, I want to play some of your poignant moments from the show.
Most people don't have their destiny and their dreams manifested because they don't have the drive to go with it, right?
Mm.
So you've got to have that drive that will get you over the hump. A lot of times, you know, that last 10% of that journey up Stone Mountain is where people die.
Come on.
Right? You almost there.
I'm going down now. I don't think I can finish the rest of this journey with you.
Right. So you got to be willing to see it all the way through, even when it feels like it's not going to happen. If it's your dream, your vision, you got to do it. The internet does not cultivate self-love, right? It cultivates covetousness. Like, I need to have what this other person has. And so the reason why people can't sustain something, the reason why you're going to get a RICO after you've got $1 million is because your character does not allow you to sustain what you're building.
Wow.
Anybody can have a gimmick. A gimmick is easy. I can come on here, we can do an OnlyFans, but if your character does not have you at a place where you can sustain that lifestyle, you're going to jail.
The dream is real.
When you're unhealed, you don't understand love. Mm. It's more catharsis, right?
Mm. Which is, so how are you still single? I mean, how are you just getting in a relationship if you know these things? I'm just curious.
You know what? I have no problem admitting I was a trash-ass individual. Very immature. Immaturity has nothing to do with age, but the acceptance of responsibility. So I did not accept my responsibility. I was not accountable for my actions and for and what I was doing as a man. So I did stupid stuff.
Now see, you didn't even know that you was gonna have a book full of quotes after coming on this podcast. Round of applause again for Taylor. Like, listen, you the one, not the two, man. I'm so proud, man. And then I think about too, the We Versus Me episode. I think it was episode 5. And I like, when I think about how I've taken on the responsibility of We, and I cannot stop. And it's almost like I said a couple episodes ago, I forgot what number podcast it was, but I had said something to the effect of like, it's starting to affect my money. Because I'm just not going. I'm waking up and I'm different every day. And it is better for me because it's like, what do you want to be remembered for? I know people are going to remember me for many different things, but like, what do I, Kenny Burns, want to be remembered for? And I want to be remembered for choosing We over me. Clearly evident in my family, clearly evident in my friend circle, clearly evident, you know, with the nation and how I show up for my people. But I just think that episode was so crazy because it's like really defining of what we need to do going forward. Is it like that in your lives too? Because I'm seeing as we do these podcasts and we title them, it's almost like a call to action.
What stood out to me about episode 5, We Versus Me, is when Ebony talked about how some couples operate in me and not we.
Word.
And that is absolutely correct. Like when you become a couple, you're married with someone else, you're supposed to be looking out for one another.
Facts.
If I'm going to get me something to eat and I know you haven't eaten, hey, are you hungry?
Yeah.
I'm going here. If you want me to pick you something up, I'll get you. If you want something else, I'll pick that up.
Right.
But that's what I took from We Versus Me. It's us.
Yeah, it is.
There's no I in team.
Yeah. Teules?
This show is like a counter to what culture is trying to push out there, right?
Mm.
So you see this, so many podcasts or so many where we have become so consumer, just infatuated with me, right?
Right.
Everything is me, me, me. And it seemed like that episode was, again, this podcast, this is your vision. It feels like God is saying, hey, look, let's straighten some of these crooked places out.
Right.
We can't have this me, me, me mentality if we're going to have a better community,
Fact.
To have better relationships, to have better business partnerships, right? It's like, it's almost as if we see something out there on the platform and it's like, God's like, okay, well, let's do We Versus Me.
Yes.
Right. So
yes.
Let's give a perspective to where we don't have to have, you know, a culture of women who are narcissistic, men who are misogynist. Let's do we, right? How do we get back to, we don't have to hate each other.
Facts.
Right. We don't have to have relationships about, you know, girl, I want to be single. I don't need no man. Yes, you do.
Yes. Hello. We all need somebody.
Yes, you do. You need somebody.
Yeah, and you get to licking on your friends. That ain't what you really want to do. Then you're confused and you're still doing drugs. And
oh,
all of a sudden you just
wait a minute.
Yeah, dive on your head off the roof. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to choose violence.
But you know what? Let me say something real quick about that, because when we are not living in community, we don't have any sounding board to go off of, whether it's a platonic or romantic relationship.
Right.
Like, you just out here doing whatever you want to do. We're supposed to be in community with other people.
No, facts.
We are supposed to be in community.
Facts.
So that episode was really good because it hit on all of that. It wasn't just talking about romantic relationships. It was also talking about how you deal with folks generally. So yeah, Ev hit the nail on the head when she said that, because
Facts.
I just don't get it. Like, how you not gonna ask the person you live in the house with, do they want something to eat?
Right.
I don't even do that. Like, if I leave work and go get something to eat, I'm gonna send in the group chat. 11 people in this group chat, because that's how many people on my team. Hey, anybody need something to eat or drink?
Yes.
Like, yeah.
Yeah, big shout out to Ebony.
Think about other folks.
Yeah, big shout out to Ebony.
Yes.
Great. She did that, Evie.
Love it.
God did his big one with her.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
She's the biggest. It's so funny because we had another episode, Cancel Culture. And it's amazing how lately, and I know everybody's seen the Big Facts podcast clips, and I have, you know, Crystal Renee coming out, and, you know, I am really going crazy with the delivery on how this generation is showing up and, in my words, fucking up the money. And although they're becoming millionaires off of Pound Town and the ops and all the negative things, right? They're fucking up the money because, ladies and gentlemen, they're not going to get another chance. Listen to the words that are coming out of my mouth. They're not going to get another chance. So we're not canceling anything. We're checking what we created. We created this $1 trillion business that you are benefiting from. We created this ecosystem of freedom that you are participating in. But what you're not realizing is that you're more special than your offering. What you're not realizing is you're playing into the beast's hands, the devil's hands. This is not by accident. This is by design. You actually, the creatives have the power, not who distributes or manufactures your ideas or your likeness. You have the power. So when you hear somebody like Kenny Burns go to podcast and I'm talking about you, I want you to know, when I'm talking about a generation of inconsistency in art and delivery, I want you to know. And I don't want you to feel good about it. Because guess what? You can't feel good about something and then repeat it if you know it's negative. I want to break that down. You can't expect to change or want change if you don't change. You can't expect a relationship you want to have if you don't do the things to put yourself in that. You know what I'm saying? Like, we are the most detrimental to ourselves. We continuously want money over favor. Can I just ask y'all what money can do to favor? Favor keeps you in play. Money has you here today. Favor keeps you in play. Money That's has right. you here today. You cannot. So,
That's good.
So the cancel culture, you know, energy. Thank you very much. The cancel culture energy is, we're not canceling y'all. We're trying to show y'all y'all fucking up. Then we gonna be good.
It's just it's the enablement of accountability that has been lacking.
Yes.
Nobody is holding anybody accountable, so they feel like they're getting canceled. But baby, actually, you're getting paused because you're not ready. Because you think that you're ready and you're not. You're moving into spaces that you shouldn't be in because you haven't done the work to get there.
Facts.
Just because you got the money to pay to play, like you said, KB, favor is not going to keep you there because your personality, your will to do the work, that's going to keep you there.
Right.
You're not being consistent. You don't want to work.
Yeah.
You just want to be there. And just because you got a couple of coins or you might be doing a little credit card fraud.
You feel?
You know, you here, scamming you just ass. Here because you can be.
Nah, listen, you dead right. And the problem is, what that saying they got, money's a root to all evil.
That's they in say, the Bible.
You know what I'm saying? That's
love in the Bible. Of money is the root of all evil.
You feel me? Right. And, but we are seeing the evil that money has created. I'm talking about across the board. From Donald Dump to Sexy Red. You see how money has people doing things that is not good for the people. Ladies and gentlemen, I say it all the time. 90% of the world are following. They're participating, which is totally fine. The 10% that's leading is responsible. So if you're a small fraction that's responsible for the bigger fraction, how do you not pour the right things into? I was at the gym this morning. I literally said, you know, it was a white woman, my partner who owns the gym, who's black, and me. And I was talking to him about how the big facts thing was going crazy. And like, I don't know if I didn't realize it was going to go that viral. Right. I was like, they want Kenny to turn up. They want turn up Kenny. They want turn up preacher, pastor, big on. That's what they want. Right. And so I said, I'm meeting people where they're at. I said, but I'm not going anymore. And it was just the fact that I said a few minutes ago, I'm waking up every day with a better version of myself. And yes, I have to stop X, Y, and Z. And yes, I'm going to stop this eventually. And I'm going to do these things because the mission I'm on is change. So if I'm not changing and I'm suggesting someone else change, I am a hypocrite like the rest of these false prophets, right? But I'm talking to the lady and she was talking about she was at the Drake concert. And I want everybody to hear this because I think you, Drake, you, sir, are the change we need. But there is some adjustments to your game that you have to make. This lady was in there with her kids. I think she has a 13-year-old son, daughter, whatever. And it was a big anime floaty with titties in the ass. A Chinese woman, she said it was clearly Chinese. And on the breast, they had stickers, right? And I was like, that's Drake walking the line. She was like, what do you mean? I was like, well, Drake is arguably one of the best artists, or, you know, rappers, hip hop artists in the history of the world. And to be honest, he's in my top five. She's like, really? I was like, yeah, he's in my top five. I said, but what Drake does is that he plays the game. Drake will put 21 Savage on his tour just because 21 Savage has a whole certain thing, right? He will also say Sexy Red is his wife in the picture because it's for the internet. He don't believe that. He not even going there. Matter of fact, any woman that has ever been around him or dated him will tell you he's a nice guy. You know what I'm saying? So it's hard for me to believe that you can't just continue being the artist that you were meant to be, making the love-oriented, figure it out, you know what I'm saying, anthems you make, and not even glorify none of that bullshit. So here's my call to Drake. Drake, you are there. You don't need another cosign. You don't need another guest feature. You are now where Jay-Z is. Okay, you have brands that want to do business. You have people giving you planes. You are there. No more do you have to even co-sign that. So if you don't really agree with it and you don't fuck with it, don't fuck with it. And so that's where we are. And I look at, actually, when I think about, you know, who's in charge, you know, and I'm skipping episodes, I think that's 22, but who's really in charge? The creatives, ladies and gentlemen. The creatives are the ones in charge. We are not beholden to anything else but what we want to do, because you got to want to do it. I can't think that Future really wasn't doing that, them drugs and all that, making them amazing melodies and going psychedelic on us. I can't. He was doing it. He made some amazing music. Honestly, I can't even. But okay, the other side of that is what? The other side of that is our baby's organs are not functioning at 25. Right? So, okay, cool. You know better. You were in a state, right? I'm not knocking nobody that had a dependency and made some art. I'm not knocking nobody that started out with drug money to get going. America has done far worse. Okay? Your government has done far worse. Okay? I'm not knocking none of that. But when you continuously go forward as if that's a part of your playbook, you are a problem. And if you don't know you're a problem, Unk is here to tell you. Big Unk is here to tell you. You are a problem. And that's why when I get into, like, you know, even like episode 29, the feeling, like, I pray you have this feeling of clarity. I pray. I pray. I dream about you having this level of clarity, because the feeling is what we're all after. You think it's money. You think it's sex. You think it's material items, you think it's things, but the feeling is how you feel with this podcast, how you feel with the information you receive that makes you want to be a better person. You want to do better with your life. And yes, it's painful sometimes to look in the mirror and fucking know that you got some fucking issues, like we all do. We've been unpacking them like a mother sucker on this podcast. But The glory comes at the brink of change.
Come on here.
The glory comes at the brink of change. You cannot possibly.
Yes, it does.
You cannot possibly get there without saying it out loud. One, huh? I don't want nobody to let that go over their head. You cannot possibly get there without saying it out loud. And guess what? If you are mute, because some of us are, some of us go through life as mutes. They playing the game. They taking a check. They just existing. But if you're not a mute, there are people that are speaking for you. Right here. Right here. The things you are scared to say, you can get them right here. Oh, point them in this direction. And guess what? That's you speaking. That's you sharing how you feel and how you want to show up. TKBS Nation, this podcast is brought to you by the good folks at American Express. With Amex, every day can feel like a vacation. I wanted some Chinese food. Yes, I got what I wanted at Mr. Child's. And guess what I used to pay for dinner with? Yes, my American Express. The dream is real. When you're with Amex, you can make every day feel like the best day ever. American Express. Don't live life without it. Bet you didn't know this. 1 in 8 people have worked at McDonald's. That's right. They went to McDonald's for a job and found so much more that was too good to pass up. Like McDonald's online high school program, where over 82,000 people received access to education. And McDonald's Archway to Opportunity, where many have developed business and entrepreneurial skills. Think about it. With McDonald's, there's a lot of power in 1 in 8. 1 in 8 have worked at McDonald's. And where you start stays with you. TKBS Nation, it's your lifestyle specialist, Kenny Burns. And child, if you're tired of those red marks on your legs from the mosquitoes, or if ants, roaches, and flies are making you angry at the barbecue, I have the answer. It's called Stim. That's right. I think it's the best mosquito repellent out. And for those ants, roaches, and flies, Stim also has a bug killer. The plant-based active ingredients and entomologists tested make it safe to use around people and pets when used as directed. The barbecue will never be the same. Keep those mosquitoes up off them. Let's put those ants, roaches, and flies in a coffin. Stim, the new wave of mosquito and bug control. And you want to know why? Because the dream is real. Tough is in your DNA. It drives your resilience. Even when they told you you couldn't, you did what no one else could. Because you're different from the rest. Every day you work hard to conquer challenges, making the impossible happen. And tomorrow you'll do it all over again with a truck that's just as tough as you. Explore the best Ford truck for you today at Ford.com. Built Ford Tough. I just learned Discover credit cards do something pretty awesome. At the end of your first year, they automatically double all the cash back you've earned. That's right. Everything you earn doubled. All the cash back from eating at your favorite soup dumpling restaurant, doubled. All the cash back from that trip where you sort of learned to snowboard, also doubled. And the best part, you don't have to do anything ridiculous to get it. Nope. Discover does it automatically. Seriously though, see terms and check it out for yourself at discover.com/match. This episode is sponsored by eBay Authenticity Guarantee. With eBay Authenticity Guarantee, you know you're getting the real deal. Whether you're looking for a head-turning handbag or a watch that says it all, jewelry that makes you look like the gym, or sneakers and streetwear that make every step feel fly. These days, to know for sure you're getting the real deal, go straight to eBay. When you're searching, just look for that blue check mark. It will say Authenticity Guarantee. That means when you buy it, you can be confident that it's authenticated by real experts. It's nothing like getting something and knowing it's real. Listen, when you're finally ready to buy that thing you love, you have to make sure you're not going to catch a fake. Facts, they're everywhere, and it's really tough to tell the difference for yourself. With eBay Authenticity Guarantee, that's easy. So again, look for the blue check mark. That way, when it hits your doorstep, not only do you know it's real, but the feeling you get when you put it on is also for real. Ensure your next purchase is the real deal. Visit ebay.com for terms. I need some other episodes that really drove home with y'all, because I just feel like we share so much information over this last year.
When you interviewed the two young ladies that we're living internationally on episode 10, Hey Young World, the world is yours.
Yes.
I said, these girls are wise beyond their years, because there is not, I can't remember a time in my 20s that I was that aware and that intentional about things. And so whenever I listen to them and talk and listen to how they're talking about what they would want from other Black women of all generations,
right?
How we need to come together and help each other and realize that we're not in competition, but we need to collaborate. Fact. I said, listen.
Yeah, round of applause for Nyla and Lindsay, because and Nyla was in Zimbabwe or some motherfucking where she was looking out the window every 2 minutes.
She was in Kenya.
Yeah, she was in Africa. I don't know. she was looking out the window for rhinos. She was like, yeah, we just was outside. Right. There was some big rhinos.
And then the other one was living in Germany.
Yeah.
I wish I would have lived internationally in my 20s, or at least been in New York or something.
Absolutely.
I've been in Kentucky and Georgia. Exactly. That's it.
Yo, matter of fact, let's listen to some of the amazing offering they gave.
I think it's always important to go ahead and recognize, you know, the ones that have given us a way to follow and pave that way for us, because nothing can be done on your own. No one has thought of anything under the sun. Nothing is new. So it's like, basically giving that acknowledgement to whether it be your grandparents or the artists before you, or that help. Who was that help? Who was that example to you? And I think that's super important, just acknowledging that, giving people their flowers, because you never know where you'll be, and we all have to continue to evolve. So right now we are current, but we will be that later, and there will be someone else current after us. When I was first working a job, I always thought of myself as being like a supermodel pharmacist, because I was in pharmacy.
Hold on. But I always... Lip gloss, okay.
So I always felt like just because I'm doing pharmacy and I'm doing a career job, I do have this, you know, fantasy to be like a supermodel because I just get that. But I did transition into a completely different career. I live in Berlin, Germany. I'm an international entrepreneur, and I am still making sure that I represent myself in a way that I wouldn't mind others repeating it, but I'm still me.
Yeah, listen, another round of applause for Lindsay Nightline. I think the future is bright. We have a real, you know, crew of youngins, man, that's really about that life, you know? Mm-hmm. And then I think about even episode 32, you know, with the propaganda episode. I've never seen so much propaganda in my life.
That was a crazy one.
You know what I mean? Like, we literally, every day, we wake up to, you know, false messaging. You know, we were just talking about the credit card scheme, you know, episode 51. And I talking about, I was waking up and I see that. I'm like, this propaganda is out of control because people are really falling for it. And I admit, yeah, I went through it, but I had to pay it. And I don't think people really realize they got to pay it. And so then you get this, these credit reports. Then you want to, you fall in luck, you want to get a house, but your credit shot because you got 27 credit cards because you listen to Roscoe on IG. You know what I mean? And it's showing up.
They need a quadrant cleaning on them too.
but it's unbelievable, the propaganda, and we're falling for it, you know? And I think about our episode, the year in review, I think it was episode 12. We were so, like, that was, talk about that. How do y'all feel about episode 12? I'm jumping all over the place, but that was so beautiful.
I know. The energy alone in that room was amazing.
Yeah.
Like, you can hear it, even the feelings and the emotions of everyone when they were speaking.
Right.
I know it was an emotional time for me because I re-listened to that episode and I almost cried.
Right.
Because I know that at that time I was going through some things, and so it triggered me in some of the things that we were talking about, like when we were talking about the individuality of you, or when you're going through some things, how much can you take in a relationship,
right,
to the
right
foundation crack?
Right.
And some of the other women and men in the room kind of felt that. You could just feel the energy in the room, just the emotions, and oh my God.
Yeah,
it was excellent.
You know what? Let's hear an excerpt from that show.
I am very independent. I ask nobody for a single thing. However, when a man is in my life, I know how to adjust and let him be a man. There is nothing wrong with having a relationship and being independent. There is balance in all of it. Right. So don't listen to women that are upset, mad.
You don't,
I don't need a man. All of that. Don't take that energy in. Because they are still upset and mad. And even if they got a husband, half the time they don't even like him.
Come on.
I'm 26. So, you know, I got my little sister's going to come up. I'm new, being my mid-20s, older mid-20s and all that sort of thing. But I can say I am a woman who grew up not having relationships. I'm a woman who grew up with a very guarded mother in a city, like an up north city. And the pattern there is, as a young woman, like, oftentimes you get pregnant, get Section 8, get your apartment. That's kind of like the pattern that's repeated.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so, like,
come up.
Like,
come
for up. Me, I was like, okay, I'm going to be the college girl and I'm going to do that. And I keep doing that. But I kind of got the independent woman syndrome. So I never really had relationships. But now, going into my older 20s, I'm kind of like,
feel different.
You know, I'm trying to work through that challenge of, like, wait, what is the submission?
Relationships today, it's very trying. It's very triggering. You have to deal with your own personal insecurities, your own personal trauma, your own personal grief, if you have that in your life.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to work on those things if you want to be with a partner and partner up with someone mm-hmm. who may have the same issues as you.
Woo! Having everybody in the room is something we must do again this year. Tiffany, let's get the plan in the year in review. That's when we're going to do the celebration that we want to do for the anniversary. So we're going to have us a Christmas party.
Perfect.
/ year in review for TKBS Nation. So if you are listening to this podcast mm-hmm. and you want to be involved, get with Tiffany. We're going to have a whole production this year and really, you know what I'm saying, have another moment like that. That was special. Round of applause for us. We great. Yeah. We special. We necessary.
Kevin, you going to be in there with your face red, what?
Because it's growing, yeah. Because last year, I think we had like 28 people. Like, I'm sure this year is going to be a packed house.
Oh, yeah.
And I want to open it up. To the entire nation. Like, I'll get the gathering spot, Tiff, whatever we need to do to like have a real live forum, mics in the audience so people can talk and have just have a real yes. yeah. Get Mike Johnson and let's do it.
Yeah.
Another right. special episode, y'all, and we've had so many 52 of them actually with this one. What was you like that? You like that? You feel me? Listen, because what people don't realize is, Sugar, like this was, I left V103 and the next week we had a podcast. I had something to say. The nation had something to say. The DMs were crazy always. The comments were crazy always. And we created this for us, by us, and we're doing it. But episode 39, uh-huh. y'all, the gatekeepers versus the hatekeepers.
Man.
Woo! You know, I think we really ruffled some feathers with that episode, you know. I think we talk about a little bit of all of this on every episode because it kind of plays a part, right? But that was special. Ooh, that was special. We were really like, set, you know, we were drawing a line in the sand. We were separating. And ladies and gentlemen, separation is amazing for you when it's your mm-hmm. season. Do not let that go over your head. Separation is amazing for you when it is your season. Because your Amen. Season, your season's all about understanding and being present for where you are. Your season will put you where you need to be, but you got to be present. And you have to be ready to get on the other side of that line now, because if you stay in the wrong place, the season will pass. Stay in your season. That's a whole nother episode.
I feel like you be having my phone lines tapped. I literally no KB.
Crazy.
Literally the wow. same words. I just said to Kendra the other day. I said, you know what? Right now, I really need to focus on me and building what I need to build with the people that I need to build it with.
Yes.
And I'm gonna have to pull back from some folks, even though I want to build with them too. Right now might not be the time. I literally, right. yesterday.
Listen, and that staying in that mindset will keep you where they at and where y'all at right now. There won't be any advancement. And this is why, matter of fact, hear this clip from gatekeepers versus hatekeepers. Black folks is the biggest culprit of this. And I want to talk to you motherfucking house Negroes one second, okay? I'm going to stop saying nigga. Because you niggas make me sick. You niggas make me sick, okay? And the problem I have is that you get in these positions of power, right? And you want to assert your personal agenda more than you really want to help your people. You rather make a decision and fuck something up instead of do what you know is going to help you not only grow, but your people have a ladder into the window, a key to the door. But you gonna go on and do it for sake of the power you think you got. Do you know that's not your power to have? Do you know that?
Right.
Do you know these positions weren't made for you? You are a vessel, huh? You are not in control of this. You are a vessel. And the more we keep giving the power, hello? To these people that don't know what the fuck to do with it, this AI shit will come in and take over the world, okay? This algorithm will keep telling humans how to be human. Do you not feel that in your spirit? You are making way, and I'm talking to everybody that's feeling this in their gut. If you feel a way about what I'm saying, you're part of the problem. You letting algorithms take the place of human emotion. Human emotion? That's the only way you ever bought rap music. That's the only way you ever celebrated jazz. That's the only way we got here. You think you created rock and roll? No, we did. It was the pain.
Hello.
It was the pain. Mm. It was the chitlins. You made us eat because we couldn't get the goddamn meat on the fucking cow. Yeah, hello?
Pete.
But we want a steak. Not bacon or chitlins. You know, bacon came out of necessity because they didn't want that pig. That pig looked different. And they get, anyway, child, I wasn't alive.
I'm still going to eat bacon. I'm going to let y'all live.
Oh, no, every Sunday. I asked 19 Keys. I told y'all that, right? 19 Keys said he can't be friends with people that eat bacon. I said, well, player, you love me, right? He's like, yeah. I said, well, I eat bacon on Sunday. Child, cheese. You're talking about peeling that onion back again. And then the eyes are starting to water. I feel, yeah, it is crazy. Like, can we just be grown without emotions? I want to be grown without all the emotions, you know, because once you get to, you'd be like, why? Have you been in a conversation lately? Your eyes just start watering up and like, what's wrong? Well, nothing's wrong. I'm actually happy. I'm just so happy that the tears are starting to.
Yeah.
Whoa. Yeah, sorry. I just need a collection play. I am tapping in. But we do. It's time. We got to be the number one podcast in the world. And I'm claiming that today. On our year anniversary,
yes.
I am claiming the number one podcast, the number one media, destination in the world. Because this is the most necessary conversation. I was listening to Big Facts, and I was listening to, like, what we're doing. And ladies and gentlemen, when I tell you the calm version of Kenny Burns pierces through so much more. Now, I know on certain podcasts, I got to show up so I can meet my people. I'm going to meet you where you at. But like this, you can really hear it. You can really feel it. You know what I mean? And with this next offering in episode 53 with the new backgrounds and the, you know what I mean, that y'all about to have, they about to continue to see the growth. Hold on, y'all didn't hear that, huh? I didn't bust that gun yet. We busting that gun for success in the air like it's New Year's Eve. But I just, you know, I feel so blessed, man. Another one of my favorite episodes where they cloned Tyrone.
That was a good one too.
Yeah,
it's hard to figure out which ones are your favorites because it's like every week we'd be like, oh, now that one was that thing. And then the next week we'd be like, oh no, now that one was that thing.
But that's the gratifying piece. And ladies and gentlemen, we're giving you one a week. So you have a whole week to digest, share. You know what I'm saying? And come back to us with some new. And everybody know this. I done chose a topic from everybody in the nation. It's not, you know, Kendra and Coco and Kenya all in one and gave me. No, you have. You see? That's why we got a whole meme face moment for you on this episode. Just because of shit like that. I was giving you flowers and you navigate. Just because I ain't tell you. The only person on here I gave credit to. I did give credit to Teules and Sugar. Never gave you credit. I'm giving you a credit to. I love you. A round of applause for Coco, Kendra, Kenya.
Whatever.
The point is, I've taken them from Nation members. I get DMs, people in the comments, inspire titles. Because these are the things we need to talk about. Coco, Kenya, Kendra, so
it's a sibling rivalry for me.
Yeah. No, it's facts. But I want to do this as we get to wrap up episode 52. It's our anniversary. That's the name of the podcast. It's our anniversary.
It's our anniversary.
Generational curses was one of the biggest we've delivered to date, you know, and it's because we grown and we still unpacking. And so to the youngers out there that's trying to figure it out and going through the motions, you could tell by that episode alone that, you know, we understand that we still going through it too. But the key is we live a little more life than you. And all we want to do is tell you what we know. All my nieces, nephews, godchildren, that I know and don't know. We only telling you what we know. The rest we learn together. And that's the purpose of that episode. What about that episode hit home for you guys?
I think that we normalize things that we are accustomed to. So we see somebody do something, then we do it. And we don't necessarily even think about whether it is something that we need to do or something that we're just doing because it's familiar to us.
Yes.
So That episode really highlighted a lot of that for me. And it also made me realize that all curses are not negative. Ooh. Because some things that you pick up along the way are good to take with you. Things you need to throw in the trash. Actually, you need to throw them in an incinerator.
Yes.
But yeah, get rid of them. Blow them up. All of the things. Don't put them in the recycle bin because they do not need to come back.
Yeah.
However, It is very important to know what you need to take with you on the next journey, because some things need to go with you on the next phase of life, and some things literally do not.
Yeah, you have to grow through some things, y'all.
Without
test, there's no testimony. Round of applause for your face. It's your face with the delivery. Taylor, you was about to say something, brother.
You know, it's just the fact that that episode helped us to be so vulnerable, and vulnerability allows people to kind of let their guards down, right? Mm. It's easy to connect with someone when you know you understand someone else is going through that, right?
Facts.
A lot of times people will go into their shell when they feel like, man, I'm out here on this island by myself. I've been going through this. It's my family. But when you hear somebody else say, hey, man, I've been there. I've messed up credit. I've lost a house. I've messed up marriages. I've done it. And I'm back on my feet. Here's how you overcome that. That allows somebody else to say, man, okay, I'm not as bad as I thought I was, right? And you give yourself grace to hear the advice. A lot of times, again, I'm not trying to down anybody else's podcast, but that vulnerability is not there, right? It's just a bunch of talking points and a bunch of bullet points of not saying anything.
Right.
And the person goes off like, ooh, child, that was good, but you haven't learned anything.
Right.
Because you haven't let your guard down enough to hear, to implement, and to move forward with that information. So I think that episode helped people. I was getting DMs like, man, you know, just your vulnerability and your truth. You know, I admire that. I'm not doing that for, you know, crowd attention. I want people to understand, like, yo, I am a masterpiece that is a mess.
Right.
And I have the ability to be both. I'm a masterpiece that God has created, and I'm a lump of clay that he has to continue to throw down on that clay wheel, but he's molding and shaping me, and that could be anybody. You don't have to stay where you're at. You can be molded if you just allow the potter's hands to do that. So that vulnerability allows that type of access to information.
Come on.
Yes.
Together.
All the potter wants to
put you back together. Be making me
want
to go to
church. Hold on, go to church. We was just in church. I listen, if I was in that chair during the pandemic right now, you know it'd be time for a praise break. Dun, dun, dun.
You made my day. You came my way.
Look, she's going to church. Listen,
Kendra be sliding me in too, baby.
Yeah, she ain't been to church in a while. I want to say this. I want to say this as we wrap up episode 52. It's our anniversary. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm right again. I chose you beautiful humans, and you have beyond impressed me during this journey. I appreciate the three of you, and I appreciate the entire nation, y'all. Like, because to be honest with you, this has been so helpful to me. Yeah, it's okay. You okay? You're gagging over.
Hey, man, see that? I'll ride again. Yeah. Myself on the back.
Yeah, I'll ride again. Because y'all, listen, and this is all of us, to Taylor's point, we are worthy. We are worthy, y'all. Like, we do not have any limitations other than the limitations we put on ourselves. This is proof positive that you can see something through and really do it in a major way.
Yes.
So I love y'all. I'm thankful for y'all. This has been an amazing episode. Episode 52. It's our anniversary. And on the count of three, you know, because next week when y'all see us, it's going to be looking a little different. All right. It's going to be some bells and some whistles. And this is, you know what I'm saying? The last time that Kendra will lead us into some shit that we ain't in sync on. But today she going to do it again. Let's go, baby. Can you warn us before you go, though?
Yes. One, two, three.
The dream is real. Yeah, we was almost there. It's the Kendra Taylor Show. Well, yeah, we did it. The dream is real. This episode of The Kenny Burns Show is brought to you by Stem, who I think has the best mosquito repellent and ant, roach, and fly killer. If you don't want those crittity critters crawling all in your crawl, get Stem and get rid of them all.